If he's going to show his hologram a sniper or get him platinum rank on a hunter, but with a twist. For those that just want to see this and skip to timestamps, yeah, available to you. Other than that, I can discuss what loadout I'm going on about. So the Devil's Lair Grandmaster Nightfall is up this week, so I'm not going to go into the modifiers because they are the same modifiers week upon every time it comes up this Nightfall. So, and I've covered it enough to talk about it, so I'm not going into it. So what I'm going on about is the Exotic Gauntlets Oathkeeper. These have a unique pairing when you pair it with the exotic bow Lamanarch. Obviously, they are an exotic based on bows. It states bow charges can be held indefinitely. It just means that you can hold, when you're drawing a bow, you can hold that for as long as you want. Whereas, generally with a bow, the standard play is, eventually the bow will fire, even if you've got your trigger held. Right? So, that doesn't sound interesting, but it has a unique pairing with Lamanarch. Because how Lamanarch works is you basically need to get a fully drawn bow to make it poison. But it doesn't always be poison, even if you do that. Right? But for the most part, it's really consistent, this bow. I'm not trashing it at all. It's, in my opinion, it's probably my favourite bow in the game. Like, exotic-wise. There's a lot of good exotic bows, but this is my favourite one. But what I'm saying is, this bow is even more consistent when you pair it with Oathkeeper, because every bow that you do, so now it's not just some, like, 80% of the bows are poison, 100% of the bows are poison, even if you don't fully charge your bow shot, like, if you just whiff your bow, it still does the poison damage, because of this, from what I've seen. So, it makes it even more consistent than what it is, but it's super consistent as it is. And I'm not saying that you need to use these. I haven't seen this on Reddit and done a run of it. In my conclusion, do you need to be running these? No, you don't. But it's kind of fun with Lamanarch if you're just using Lamanarch a lot on a hunter. So that's the loadout. In terms of everything else, we're using a Braytech or a rifle with major spec in it, just in case we do need to break a shield. But we had stasis, we really didn't need the auto. I went double primary so I would get more heavy. That's the only reason why I really done that. Lamanarch's going to do most of our work anyways. We're using the linear fusion rifle Tarantula with boss spec, so it gives increased damage against bosses and vehicles, not just champs, so we went for the boss spec route. Then, fusion rifle ammo fine on the helmet, protective light build, so this is how this goes. Protective light, elemental charge, which gives us charge with light when we pick up an elemental well. We have font of wisdom, when we pick up an elemental well, we get the increase to intellect for 30 seconds. Elemental shards, which turns basically the stasis shards into a well. So effectively, your shards are wells. Therefore, you get your charge of light and you get your protective light all the time. You get in front of wisdom all the time. And then on this bit, we've got on the cape, we've got particle deconstruction bomber. So when we dodge, we get grenade energy, which you'll see me do that a bit. Aspects and fragments are touch of winter, grim harvest, Whisper of Chains, Whisper of Torment, Whisper of Durance, Whisper of Shards, Whisper of Fissures, and a cold snap grenade, which is a really good grenade. I'm not going to do a full commentary on this run because I have done Devil's Lair to death for commentaries, so I'm just going to basically state what the loadout was and why I'm doing it, right? But other than that, I'll just post the run up as it is. Hope you enjoy, thank you.
us.
Thank you.